90% shooter on the free throw line. Excellent numbers. He's got that great stroke on that free throw line. It's like Automatic City.
You know, you were commenting at the shoot-around today about the intensity that Kentucky has when they practice. They don't just shoot casually. They shoot with great intensity.
That really impressed me today. I told a number of writers being interviewed, I have never seen a practice session where a team, every shot is with a purpose. They're in a 2-2-1 pressure now. Constantly scratching and clawing on a defensive end.
Bounce pass into the middle, and that goes between three sets of legs before Bailey saves it.
They got to get back the ball out, back it out, run their cuts.
Mashburn knocked it out of bounds. Left until halftime. Indiana by one.
Get him the ball out of box, the big horse, the big redhead. Oh, nice look. Nice look.
You're watching the Big Ten's greatest games.
3:38 left until halftime.
I'll tell you an MVP, John Saunders in that studio. The guy does an amazing job.
Yes,
Mr. Saunders, I'm going to be his PR agent. Oh, great drive.
Pat Graham is blocked by Brasso, but he also was fouled.
We talked in that earlier, the fact that you really can't give a lot of help defensively. Now watch Woods' penetration here. He takes it to Billy, now he draws the help. He draws help and he kicks the ball out, and it's a wide open J because the help and recover doesn't work with that kind of penetration. Excellent move by Woods, and certainly Mr. Farmer finalizing. I don't think Farmer missed a shot today at practice. Graham has got that great touch. We talk about that he's the all-time consecutive guy on a free throw line, 38 in a row before missing this season over last year and this year. That's a record in Indiana. He misses one.
You knew if you said anything, it'll stay with the Hoosiers. Pelfrey with eight to lead the way for Kentucky. Anderson with six.
This guy Lawson could be an important player. Had a big game against Louisville. Get him the ball out of box, the big horse, the big redhead. Oh, nice look. Nice look. That's high percentage basketball. That's why you shoot 56%, Ron. There's a good look by Bailey. He dumps it. Now look at Lawson. He's got great vision with his size, 6'10". And I love the way Graham moves without the ball.
Pelfrey's going to have to come out. That's the third foul on him. So Kentucky has played a majority of the first half without Hanson, who got in foul trouble just about 10 minutes ago. And now Pelfrey has to come out. Not good.
Really danger time right now for Rick Pitino. You got 3:24 on the clock. This is a segment of the game that's really important in creating some momentum. And you have two of your stars sitting next to you as an assistant coach. Here's where Indiana has to make a run.
5-point lead almost stolen. Brasso.
Oh,
my goodness. He is going to go to the line for three, and he came close to getting a 4-point opportunity.
That's the new rule now in college basketball. If you're fouled and attempting the 3-point shot, you get three opportunities.
Well, this Sunday, NFL game day, noon Eastern time. Chris Berman of the game with a comprehensive look at the day's action. Then NFL primetime at 7 Eastern time. Base highlights, scores, and playoff. Followed by the Broncos and the Seahawks at 8 o'clock. And, of course, Seattle's playoff hopes still alive.
Bobby Knight's first game against Kentucky was his debut against the Baron, Adolph Rupp. And what a shootout that was, Ron. You and I talked about it. 90-89. Knight wins that game, led by Steve Downing, who had unbelievable numbers. Yeah, what his numbers were, unreal.
47 points and 26 rebounds.
And he played 50 minutes.
It was a double overtime.
And he played 50 minutes.
31-28. As we're about to hit 3 minutes.
Oh, there's the rear screen by Lawson. Indiana really lays the screen. Oh, he had the wide open jumper. Should have shot the ball there.
Brasso went in the air, and Graham, instead of moving either to the side or forward, and stayed right where he was, and Brasso caught him in the side of the head with his hand.
See, in that opportunity right there, Pat Graham should have stroked that ball. Ricky Pitino has brought so much life to this Kentucky program. He was the perfect guy to take over with all the turmoil that was existing. I've said it once, I'll say it again. In the mid-90s, when you start the mid-90s, Kentucky, year in and year out, will be in the top 10 in the nation because of that guy's leadership.
By the way, that's the third foul on Brasso. So now Kentucky with a situation with Hansen, also Pelfrey, and now Brasso with three. And Jody Thompson is coming off the bench, and Rick doesn't want to take a chance on Brasso picking up a fourth with just under 3 minutes to play till halftime.
Both these clubs are going to be improved next year. Indiana adds Allen Henderson, and I'm talking about one of the five marquee high school players in America from out of Indianapolis who can step in here and be a major factor next season. They only lose one senior, Lyndon Jones.
Steps called against Kentucky.
Mashburn, to me, has not really been as animated and hasn't been as active as I've seen him in the past. He's a much more talented player than what we've witnessed here in his first half. See, now it goes the trap again. Post up to the middle, then try to get the triangle.
Almost an air ball. Sean Woods, and that's going to be a reach-in against Damon Bailey.
Indiana really not taking advantage of Pelfrey and Hansen on that sideline in the last 4 minutes.
Coming up, Darren Feldhaus hits the half-court shot to narrow the Indiana lead at halftime. Welcome back to the Big Ten's Greatest Games. Kentucky at Indiana, December 18th, 1990.
Chris Reynolds will come in, and Greg Graham will come over and take a seat. And Reynolds, probably for his great defensive ability, coming in here in the waning moments of this first half.
We just passed that Kentucky bench, and we go to peek at Bernadette Locke, and what an amazing job she has done. Ricky Pitino told us she's the liaison between all the players and the academic end of it, and right now they had six players with a better than three-point average this past semester, and the average, and there she is, the beautiful Miss Locke. And I'll tell you something else. She does a great job at practice, actually, on the court teaching.
Played at Georgia.
This is an All-American.
Knocked away by Mashburn, almost stolen. Both of the Grahams for Indiana with 7 points apiece to lead the scoring for the Hoosiers. 2:33 remaining till halftime. Indiana by three.
Kentucky always using a trap. There's the trap right now. Now reverse the ball. The trap creates the turnover. He's got a trailer.
Feldhaus fouled by Jones.
Feldhaus getting his first start tonight. I really believe not only because he had the big performance and they wanted to go bigger in size, I think psychologically Feldhaus really didn't respond from coming off the bench. There's the trap. There's the reverse. Good anticipation by Woods. They pop the ball. Now he's got the trailer. He kicks it back. Feldhaus is a power player. He's going to take it up strong, and he gets fouled. See, I think psychologically, Ron, he was not adapting to the role of coming off the bench. And I think Ricky Pitino, who knows his people, said to himself, maybe if I start him now, Brasso can handle coming off the bench.
Indiana over 10 fouls, so Kentucky at the line for a couple. As you can see, Feldhaus misses the first, bangs his hands together. Cuts it to two.
Now he rotates to the foul line. He's going to go into a trap. 1-2. So he's going to lead the defense, match up. Indiana spreads, trying to take away the opportunity to trap by extra spacing. But there it comes. And that's where you want to go with it, right at that post area. Bobby Knight was using a term yesterday. Don't hide against the trap. Make yourself available. Oh, he missed Lawson. Constant motion. Ricky Pitino said today at practice, you're going to get screened like you've never been screened in your life.
Graham kicks it back outside. Flashes inside. Bailey is there, and he misses the short jumper.
That's the way Bailey scored big in high school. The average of 30 a game, as we look at the turnover, he was a post player as well as a perimeter player.
Pat Graham is a more confident basketball player than we saw this summer at the Olympic Festival. Agreed?
Well, that's
he looks to me like it.
That's what PT will do for you. Get a lot of playing time. You start to produce. You start to have success. I get a kick out of people who say, you got to have confidence. How could you have confidence when you're not playing and you're not scoring? Success makes confidence. Look, he's got confidence. He wants the run. He wants the run.
Up inside, and he'll get a chance to make it a three-point play.
He says, I can play now. Get me the ball. Ron Franklin says, I got confidence. He was Mr. Basketball out of high school in Indiana. Look at him searching. Look at his mouth. He says, give me the rock. Former can't check me. Come on, Richie. You can't play me. Are you kidding me? He said, this is no contest. I get it down in that D.
Farmer with his first.
Richie's really been a pleasant surprise this year. Lost a lot of weight and has been a real, real dynamite player off that bench.
Pat Graham now in double figures. Has 10 to lead the Hoosiers. And it's back to a five-point Indiana lead.
Not a big Indiana team out there when you talk about Meeks. You look at Jones and Graham. Everyone was playing with four guards right now, Indiana. Because Bailey could be classified as a guard as well. Well, that's a walking violation. If you're Bobby Knight, you got to be disappointed that you don't have Rick Pitino right here down at least 10 going to the last 4 minutes with the kind of people he has on the sideline in Hanson and Pelfrey. See, right now, this last minute, they got to capitalize. They got to get a deuce out of this possession or three. That's the option you wanted in that possession. You wanted to go to Graham. He's got the hot hand. See, there's the help. Forget about it.
Farmer misses on that one. He came in with a hot hand last week against North Carolina and played a big part.
I'll tell you, Woods is so effective with that penetration to create the opening for the three.
Shot clock is off. And the game clock you can see in the lower right-hand corner of your screen.
They lay those big back screens. You watch Lawson running around there laying some screens. He's going to come up and lay a screen. Here's Lawson. Hey, he's making like Sloan screen 45. Created by Fred Gadelli, an outstanding producer at ESPN. I got credit for that term, but it was Freddie.
Foul by Feldhaus with 3 seconds left until halftime.
Personal foul, Kentucky. Number 12, Kevin Feldhaus.
Indiana, to me, is one great baseline player away from being a special team. And that player could have been Lawrence Funderburk. If Funderburk would have been the kind of athlete and done the things expected and been accepted by his teammates, he would have been the guy that could take this team to the top five. I really think they'll have a tough time making a run to get to the Hoosier Dome for the Final Four because of the lack of another big athletic player.
Second foul on Feldhaus. 3 seconds left until the halftime. John Saunders will be coming up at intermission time to bring you up to date on what has happened with the top 25 tonight. Now keep it going.
Oh! Count the three.
What a house.
You talk about Uncle Mo, momentum going to that locker room. What a big three by Feldhaus. He looked like Bob Cousy, the knee up in the air, the old way. That's how I used to shoot my one-handers, baby. He lets it fly. He says it's nothing but net, baby.
So, let's take a break. It is halftime here at Assembly Hall with the Hoosiers 37 and the Wildcats 34.
Kentucky goes on a 9-0 run to start the second half.
This is the Big Ten Network.
You're watching the Big Ten's greatest games.
Well, foul trouble, and of course, Brasso, Pelfrey, and Hanson, all with three, going to have to be extremely careful.
And Pelfrey's out there as well. So they run a curl move. Excellent back screens, curl moves to get free. A lot of down screens, posting to the boxes. So many options to their offense.
Pelfrey.
That's a great play. I'll tell you, Ron, that is just a great play he just made. Feldhaus offensively rebounded.
So Feldhaus with the last 5 points that have been tallied by Kentucky, and that ball knocked out of bounds off the hands of Pelfrey. You mentioned Mashburn and his cold start. He was 0-for-5 from the floor in the first half.
I didn't think he was active enough. He just seemed to be very passive on the floor.
Also tried a three-pointer, so 0-for-6 overall.
Chaney is going to put numbers on in this half. He really is an excellent second-half player. He's practically shut out against Notre Dame. In the second half, he came out and put on about 15.
Kentucky can go back on top on this trip. Mashburn working inside. Shot still won't go for him. Melbourne misses the easy one. Indiana's missed about four layups in this game tonight.
They really have had opportunities in transition. See, here's the interesting matchup right here. Meek's playing Woods. Does he allow penetration, and do they help, or they allow him to play him one-on-one? Oh, great look. He's a key player. If Woods can break the defense down like that, they're going to get the high percentage shot.
Wildcats go back on top by one.
Indiana is very content just to break the pressure, bring the ball back out. Man-to-man defense now by Kentucky out of the 2-3 zone.
Bailey pulls up just inside the three-point line, and Pelfrey for Kentucky on the rebound.
What a great pass,
and Mashburn gets his first two. They've got to have him contribute. He averages almost 15 a game.
There's the MVP right now in a court for Kentucky, Sean Woods, number 11. He's from Indiana. He's from Indianapolis. He had great vision to make that pass to Mashburn.
Chaney for two won't go. And Pelfrey has just picked up the foul. That's his fourth.
It's probably going to go small now. Go with Brasso. Bring Brasso in, I would imagine, on a perimeter to replace Pelfrey.
Pelfrey is out, and Brasso comes in with 17:52 remaining in the ballgame.
Rick Pitino always coaching every moment he can. The guy, I don't think he sleeps. It's amazing. His work ethic is just absolutely incredible.
Meek's working against Woods.
Reverse it to Chaney. Reverse it to Chaney. Ducks him in. Back screen for Chaney along the baseline.
Nova with the jumper. Hard off the front iron, and Sean Woods. Feldhaus for three, and they're going to say turnover against Kentucky.
Sean Woods has really improved as a player. Watching him last year and watching him this year, you talk about confidence, you talk about decision-making. He has really made excellent decisions with the ball. And that's what you want out of your point guard. Give it up and go without it, Reggie. Give it up.
Hanson for three, nothing.
Should have given it up in the middle and just cut to the goal and gotten it back.
Pat Graham back in the game, feeds back to Meeks.
Great look. That's the option you want. Great look by Meeks. Foul by Bailey. Don't cry, Damon. I have to look for my all-crybaby team, my all-Bill Lampier team, Damon. Don't be a crybaby. He fouled. He definitely reached in. As soon as you reach your hand in there, they're going to blow the whistle.
You know, Dick, you go back to the three-pointer that Feldhaus hit right at the end of the first half, and Kentucky has now scored 9 straight points.
They were down 37-33.
I wasn't going to correct you.
Oh, my math. I broke down.
Don Rutledge makes the call of travel, and Rick Pitino is up doing a great imitation of an official who was making a holding call.
No, he was inviting him to Bravo Pitino's down in Lexington, Kentucky.
You think so? 40-37 our score. Kentucky leads just under 17 to play. Meeks, what a night.
Oh!
And Chaney sends it home with the third.
Chaney with the jam-a-roo. That's a high percentage shot. He's been struggling shooting the perimeter shot. He'll start putting points on the board. Chaney is a scorer.
Martinez inside, and a push against Pat Graham.
Jody Sylvester makes the call, and what I like about Jody Sylvester, he calls it with authority. Look at Chaney run the court. Great, great speed. He's got excellent vision, and he's got great hands to make the catch. There he is with the catch. Great open court player. Best open court player in college is Stacey Augmon down at UNLV. Boy, I watched them Saturday against Michigan State. What a defensive team Jerry Tarkanian has.
Chaney has picked up the foul, and that's his third.
Shooter from out there. And a man, Chaney's got the size on Woods, so he took advantage of the mismatch.
Pulled it up from 7 feet and drained it.
He's a pro. Rick Pitino said today, that's a given. He's an automatic. He'll be an excellent small forward.
Brasso for three again.
Martinez with the foul, trying to get position on Graham.
It's only the second team foul this half against Kentucky, so let's take a break. 15:56 left to play. It is the Wildcats by a couple. Bailey for three.
He wanted the ball.
Welcome back to the Big Ten's greatest games. Kentucky at Indiana, December 18th,
1990. 74-73.
Keith Smart hits that jumper from the baseline.
Martinez is the man that he's pointing at.
Bailey's an excellent driver to the goal. He just has to do it more often.
Three fouls on Martinez now. Pelfrey on the bench, he had picked up four. And, of course, Hansen has three.
When you talk about the diaper dandies, Bailey certainly got as much publicity as anybody in America. It all started back when he was in elementary school. In that book that put out by John Feinstein, Season on a Brink, they talked to Bobby Knight, talked about Damon Bailey. Then Sports Illustrated ran a story about him in the ninth grade. But he's had so much publicity, and he had a brilliant high school career, culminating it, winning the state championship in front of 40,000 at the Hoosier Dome.
Well, the 17,000 plus. He's extremely fired up right now because it is tied, and Martinez has just picked up his fourth foul. Wow.
Well, when laying that screen, Ron, you must be stationary. Martinez out of Miami, played at Miami High School, got an outstanding program. Shaky Rodriguez is the coach. Year after year, they have great players. 2-3 zone. He may go to a trap out of it.
You bet.
Bailey for three.
The ball. He stepped right into the gap and seen that it's T.O. Ricky. Good quickness defensively, good matchup. Reynolds and Woods,
fouled house.
You're watching the Big Ten's greatest games.
He really can get the ball off. See, there's the post move against the pressure.
Pat Graham with the bounce pass to Anderson, and he loses it.
That's one of the great areas in their defense. They rotate back and give help, get a blocking call. Kentucky rotates back defensively as well as anybody in college basketball. Bobby Knight, three national championships, nine Big Ten championships in his 20 years at Indiana.
Nick, I was watching you in the Indiana Louisville game. Wasn't it Reynolds who would parallel to the ground on a two-on-one break to break up a fast break?
He was amazing. He made a great play defensively. Louisville really came back since that game. They beat the ball handily, had a win over Western Kentucky yesterday. In fact, we were teasing Rick Pitino today. I said, Pitino, this game is not that big to you. It doesn't mean anything. You didn't even show up at practice last night. You went to scout Western Kentucky and Louisville. He had the answer. He said, Dick, we practiced in the morning. That just was a shoot-around. Both these clubs had double sessions yesterday.
Good feed to Bailey.
Haley in the right place to create it again by the penetration and quickness of Chris Reynolds. Good penetration to break the defense down.
Hanson for three, not there. Nover loses it momentarily.
Hanson really has been a non-factor. The foul trouble has really taken his game away from him.
Pat Graham to the hoop and a whistle inside.
Look at these numbers right here. Chasing the Barrett. 875 wins, Ron. Unbelievable. Bobby Knight has 540. If he lasts 15 years in coaching, he has to average 21.3 wins for the next 15 years. And that's what he's been averaging throughout his career. I believe, as we look at the general, that those numbers will even become more of a reality because now you play more games than you did in the early part of his career.
Bailey is out, sits down with 13 points right now as we have just over 13 minutes to play.
That record would be like catching, like Hank Aaron, catching the Babes in baseball.
Yeah, for sure. It would have that kind of magnitude.
I mentioned it tonight today before the game. He says, Dick, like, I really care about records. Like, that's on my mind right now. I said, Bobby, I just made a fact here. He's unbelievable.
7-point lead.
Oh, back cut. He missed on. Hanson was wide open with a back cut.
Feldhaus can't get it to go. Hanson on the follow, misses. He'll go to the line for a couple.
They need something from their leader right now. Reggie's got to forget about the four fouls and just pick his game up.
Personal foul, number 24, Matt Dover, his third personal, and he's fifth. Here we go.
I like the scheduling concept of C.M. Newton and Rick Pitino. Go out and challenge and play against the best to get a real true evaluation. And that's what they've done in the month of December. They have played some strong basketball teams as Hanson misses the free throw.
Hanson averages 15. He has only five tonight.
Two, two, one pressure right now. Here comes the trap. Not allowing him to get to the sideline.
Pat Graham against Brasso. And of course, Brasso with four fouls, having to be careful as Graham battles inside. And Pat misses the short jumper.
Graham has really improved his driving ability. Today ran to the three-point line.
Brasso. Open, set for it, and then missed it. Cheney sees any trouble.
Just a matter of time. He is sweet as soap. He is the best. He's an all-Big Ten performer and will be an All-American before his career is over. That man is special. Oh, they locked it up defensively.
Reynolds will pick up the foul.
You and I had an interesting lunch today, Ron, and we were greeted at lunch by Magnus Palkowski, who played here several years ago. And he really was so emphatic about stressing how this team is a much better defensive team, the Indiana team, than the teams within the last 4 or 5 years. Even the team he played on, he said, in 89, that won the Big Ten championship.
Yeah, I was surprised when he said, oh, yes, they're much better defensively than we were. Great hand for a very popular Chris Reynolds as Lyndon Jones comes into the lineup. Comfort for three, not there.
Cheney making some big plays now, rebounding, knocks down the big three. Look at Cheney working the offensive board. That's a big-time player. That's a PTP-er, baby, a prime-time performer.
Pitino wants a timeout.
He better get a timeout.
11-point Hoosier lead.
Burn to the spot.
Working against Nover, and he scores.